time he was just over bending.
Getting behind.
Yeah, and yeah. So I don't want that to happen.
Happen again, yeah. Right.
He was folding.
Very much. So, you know, this is just like,
I can't believe your leg.
Oh.
I am so loved that you have finally found this place with your leg.
Well,
it's the only place they work.
It disappears.
But they can't work properly with Clary.
Yeah,
they're here. And that is heaven.
So, if I get him to kind of move out a little bit,
he paces or he step paces or sometimes he even does a little bit
but
of a saddle.
What has to happen before you ask him to move out?
You got to ask for a vertical pole at least first. Not lateral, vertical. Because he can't raise his back if you're going to start him out with a head up and a pole up here. His back isn't going to engage to, and he's going to have to go lateral.
How much? Is that enough?
Nope.
Even more?
Yep. And then you ride him to the bit. There you go. But keep in contact with him. That head comes up, he's going right back to a pace. You're getting too fast. Take it slow. You always work gait from the slowest minute amount. Never go past and you'll hit that pace every time on a lateral horse. You should be walking him out. Before you work gait, you should be working more walk so you get that head looseness and relaxation.
Now what is that?
The shipping pace.
Okay, that's what I thought. That's what I wanted to know because I was feeling that and every once in a while, if he's really moving forward and relaxed, it feels like it's a little bit of a saddle rack.
Yep, you got to go slow though.
If you, what? It seems, you know, I love the speed.
You don't
and
get
it
to
feels,
do what you love.
It feels like there's no, not enough energy or something to do things.
You cannot have the speed first for any gait development.
Okay.
That's what gets you into pain.
Oh, okay.
Because they can't, they don't have the conditioning, they don't have the timing. Until you develop the timing, you can't move them up faster. You're not riding for what you love. You're riding for a goal that's correct. Then you get what you love. But you're going to blow right by it, and you're never going to find it. Unless you like speed and pace, in my guess.
No, I've never felt speed pace before.
Yeah.
I did it. Okay, so...
But you got yeah,
this is
walking.
This is
you're not
this
doing
is good.
Your
walking. This is good. This right here.
Oh, I want a little more extension at walk than that because I
no,
want some
I mean
impulsion.
The forward speed.
That's what I mean. I want more extension than that.
So how do I just kind of lift up and
don't lift
use
up.
More energy in my body? Or?
No, just intent forward. If you lift up, you're going to hollow his back. Just keep your back round and think forward, forward. Let's go forward.
And then if he
but lower his head, lower
he wants
his head.
To, if he wants
because
to just
he's
break into
like
a gate.
He's just not built like a possum. His neck ties in lower in his neck. So his cervicals tie in lower in that shoulder. He has got to set up differently for his gait than Rita.
So
that's
if
a pace too fast.
Yeah. Well, how do you rate that from trying
you've
to get,
get your walk
extended walk
extended
and when
walk
he, go,
and
he goes on into the...
You got to stay in extended walk for a while.
No, but what I'm saying is when I ask, when I think I'm asking for extended walk, he goes into the gate. How do I kind of rate that back?
Do a half a breath out.
Okay.
And a half hop.
Okay.
It's a half a breath out and then close his fingers. He's moving, raise him back down. And some horses, it'll be a quarter breath. Some horses, you might have to do a whole breath.
Well, this is what he's, you know, he's
you know,
been,
every horse you
he's
got
always been asked just to go, go
right.
On and go.
That's what he had before he had you.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I understand it.
Yeah. And then calm down. No more speed than that. Back down, you're losing him. Your legs are so locked and braced, your heels are down, you lost the relaxation. Your intent should come from your core, not your legs.
There's never
better, it's a little better, still a skipping pace, but I'll take this better. Now, see how he can move forward, he can release that vertical and give you a vertical pole. Because you can't get a horse to go into a bit till they have a vertical pole.
Okay.
Tie the horse to the bit, never off the bit.
Okay, that's what I was not trained to do.
And he's going to have a lower headset for his gait because of his confirmation. I had tears on his lower headset. You don't set the head. That's better. Hear that 4-beat walk?
Yes, I felt that. I heard that. And I
know
what I was doing to get it. The thing that didn't last very long.
No, but
I got there.
You got there.
Yeah.
Try it again. But you got it. Everything has to come out of that walk, because that walk is the 4-beat. That's an even 4-beat. Saddle rack is an even 4-beat.
Yes, I know that, mentally anyway.
And that sole sense of feel, and don't grab and push and brace with the leg, or he's going to get stiff, and it's going to make him pace. There's your vertical pole. Oh, there you go, there you go. Nice and slow. You've got to release and relax that pole.
There was a little bit.
That was a nice piece.
Yes. So all this, I can do and send you the video,
yes.
And that's what I'm looking for. I need
content,
what you say.
Yep.
Don't do that. Do this or
yep.
Try this. Or
this is what's happening.
This is on this. So I think that's probably it, right?
Yep.